champions of the realm. You've made it through 2020 and it's time for a rewind. So load up your rifle, spin that blade, throw those who oppose you. Wave your magic paws, grab that bow, loose those arrows, and execute the law in Paladins. Top 10 plays.
Let's give them their just desserts.
Heal, blink, kill, and this is Owly for sure. And also the last time we'll see the old Frog Isle. Smashing Tyra hard for a first blood, ice block, fast scout the next target. Who doesn't like a healer as their target? Genos has no cover to run to. Snapshot kill then drives into Barrack. That's a three. Where's the four? Terminus should have watched their back. Owly speeds over to Koga, and it's a pretty sweet stomp. But I want to show you how this ends. All good plays must come to an end, but we don't often see how it ends. Riding over to the enemy spawn to delay a common tactic, Tyra getting danced on once more, hiding in their delicious ice cream shell. The kill streak continues. Now blue pile out of the spawn, and there's no kills for a reset, no kills for a cooldown reduction, and there's a beautiful point of view getting dunked on by Terminus. A great life, a great death.
I will tear you apart!
Dudley the dragon takes a short pony ride out and narrowly avoids being charged by Rom. Payload isn't too far from being delivered, and Goodly's got a power-punching payload of his own to deliver right into the heart of Rom. Can't do much from this room, gotta get back out into the open. With two teammates down, Goodly releases a barrage upon Grub, but he just heals it back up. Docks behind Ash's shield. What a nice place to land for a resupply. Getting some leverage on the left to see the scope of the battle. Nice damage spread from that overhead fire spit. Cross chasing Victor, he'll get bombarded. Barrack's got a shield up, hop, skip, and jump overhead, double kill. Great navigation of the map. There's another heal around the corner, sends Seraphs to zero. No more healing for the tanks, another spit bomb, tracked Barrack, quadra kill, rampaging. Goodly the dragon is the greatest dragon I know, though technically, still not a dragon.
I am a one-man crusade.
It's the beautiful new Frog Isle, and Terminus, played by Pawn.com, is ready to meet the next wave as he leads the payload to its destination. Maeve makes it dark. This will initiate combat. Dives into the back. Pawn.com tracks and smacks. It's like swatting a fly. Really tricky. Eventually, though, gets them. Focusing on protecting the back line over pushing the front line. The team seems to be handling this okay. Makoa is here. Puts up a barrier against him. Saves Koga. Not going to chase. Going to keep the push going. This is not looking too comfortable as he gets swarmed by enemies. Seraph's channeling healing. The barrier is slowly depleting. Convergent Shadow Grasps 3. Pawn.com. Shadowfall. Mega Dev combo. That felt powerful. Makoa getting axed on. Quadra kill. Maeve buzzing around. Cutting those angles and toes, Pentakill on a Terminus. That's what I like to see. Show me more.
I'll feed you to me, Kraken.
Grenade launchers just aren't the kind of weapon you want for ground-to-air combat. Drogar's looking for a high place to rest. Ooh, Sword 728 gets a fantastic shot and explodes him. Around the corner, this looks to be a decent place to distribute some collateral damage. Maldamba rushes ahead. It does spook Sword a bit. He warps back, plays the jump high card, gets a good view, and that's just what we want. Glorious grouping for a whooping! Figure explosive poison sword is slaying it with every tool they have. We'll let Drogon's get away. Spread the message.
There will be no laughter when you are sentenced to death.
Mr. X-Gen gonna give it to ya in a team deathmatch on Trade District. It's about time we saw one of these. Hiding behind the caravan up ahead is nothing but highly concentrated lead and total bullet shred. Looks like we got ourselves a lexicon standoff, full head on charge, a lawful good load of lexicution!
Jeez, training dummies put up more of a fight than you.
Ogre in the quarry. The match is ready to kick off, and I wonder how many enemies expect a Koga to attack them from above, dancing on the rooftops. I mean, it looks good, but they aren't actually doing anything yet. Androxus becomes a potential target, but it's really hard to lock onto any target like this. Genos on the ledge, gonna make you feel deeply uncomfortable by violating their space. Gets the blow, and now the bullets flow. Okay, snapping to Androxus, circles him, wrong fall. What was he doing back there anyway? And where's Androxus gone? Up there, oh! How did you even get that kill? 133 health. Let's regenerate some of that before Cassie comes. It's time to switch from fight to flight. Quite literally, Barak and Victor pestering the rest of the team. Eliminates Barak on the point, switches to Victor. Wow, Dizzy, you just know exactly where people are. Every time you kill, your awareness, your clairvoyance, your game sense, whatever it is you're using, you've got a clear killing schedule, and not one person shall be late. Androxus again will carve some healing out of him. Dizzik is unstoppable. Tell us something we didn't already know.
Our light encompasses all.
People like Io so much that they're changing their name to hers. Now that's dedication. We're hiding in the quarry building. This point capture is for the game, and Red Team's already filled that camp bar up. Tyra ought to be careful walking in here. Excuse me, nicely backing away from Meldamba's ult. Couple of teammates down. Khan is gifted some healing point in overtime. No time to waste. Luna steps on the point. The goddess Io makes a quarter pounder out of them. I'm freaking loving it, but I'm still not going to eat it.
They will regret putting me through that.
Mind Shifter. Seriously, sounds like a name out of Hero Academia. So let's see what their superpower is. Bomb King getting bombed on. They actually survived that? Pretty damn impressive, but the outcome isn't gonna change. Maid's Feather Boots can't keep her in the air long enough to compete with Mind Shifter. She's tricky all alone. Target, Sidewinder, two down, three to go. Mindshifter will fight another air battle, one they can't win right now, so instead they take cover. Rocket Barrage reloaded and ready, breaking cover, spearheading the left flank, Colossal Spitball Punishment, moving and clears Meldamba on the other side. Bomb King and Druxus witness the Legion buzz through the gates. Mindshifter low, nice clutch shot, boost in your face. Druxus and Inara locked and exploded. There's Druxus, we got it. These are amazing shots. Mindshifter, aka Wings of Death.
I'm gonna bust your beats!
Pepper's home recorded videos, and this is some ambitious healing when right behind them are some comrades that will be easy to encourage to push that payload. Bomb King and Leon flank hard right. Ash pushes middle. Enemies focused on her. Aurelius is healing left, right, and center. That's unbelievable. Support of the team coordinating this push. Healing switches off Ash as she jumps in onto Leon. She's low. Hate those reload timings. Critical flash. She needs to take cover. That's not Aurelius' fault. Bouncing up the stairs. Dresco, Spinny, Maeve, and Janice get clocked. Maeve regains their body. Air shot. Boom. It's anarchy. Another air target. Androxus getting peppered. Bouncing to the payload now, full dive onto Vivian, and that is how you balance offense with support tactics.
What did you just call me? Oh, witch. Right.
Ascension Peak is looking as pretty as ever, until Great Divine comes along to blast it and everyone on it to smithereens! On the defense, the payload's surrounded by enemies and a shield we can't pierce. Great Divine will do battle with a Blade Master instead. Ice Block waits out the cooldowns in, mispredicting the exit. How fortunate! Now we're in overtime and Great Divine has yet to make an impact. This is unusual! There blows Tiberius Khan, launches our friend Rama off of the map. He pays for that now for Mary. Freaking pop in, double kill over to Grover, and it's over for Grover, two to go. Barak will be harder to shift. Blizzard's gonna help with this. Uh-oh. Getting low. Tana's holding the payload in place. Two. Both Barak and Zin getting swept up by the cold axe. The link to submit your play is in the video description below. Contact me on discord.me/Toki if you need help claiming your bounty, submitting a play of your own, or you want to find some guys, gals, and non-binary pals to hang out with. My name's Inuki, and I can't wait to see what you can do.